Hello, everybody. We know you're out there this early in the morning.
Like it's working, you did.
See if there's anybody that's tuned in yet.
You know, you come from a different age when you say things like, "Has anybody tuned in yet?" Instead of logged on or opened their Facebook. Yeah, so far, nobody. Nobody but you and me. Need were you there? Let's just sing until we get ready to go. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes he causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you him.
So this is the day in between the cross and the empty tomb. This is the odd day of rest. Never known before or since, in which the dying race of men had been for 33 years visited by their Creator. In which the dying race of men had put him to death, because they were filled with the disease of power and envy. Death, because they were afraid of death. Death, because they were all infected with the disease on some level. In which those who had seen him, this Creator among them, and loved him, were left with broken hearts, saddened minds, and fearful spirits, in which there were those who hated him because of their disease of hatred, envy, lust, which was left undiagnosed or untreated, in which the grief of those The grief of the one at his loss was accompanied by the anger and fear and hatred of those who had done him in. Neither knew that the next day would provide the answer, an answer that would tear the foundations from the one, even though more powerful, and empower the other to live and die with glory and joy unspeakable, because they knew the Creator in the one slain. O sacred head now wounded.
O sacred head now wounded, with grief and shame weighed down, now scornfully surrounded, with thorns thine only crown. O sacred head, what glory, what bliss till now was thine. Yet and glory, I joy to call thee mine. What thou, my Lord, hast suffered was all for sinners' gain. Mine was the transgression, but thine the deadly pain. Oh, here I fall, my Savior, 'tis I deserve thy place. Look on me with thy favor, vouchsafe to me thy grace. What language shall I borrow
Under an eastern sky, amid a rebel cry, a man went forth to die for me. Thorn crowned his blessed head, blood stained his every tread, cross laden on his bed for me. Pierced through his hands and feet, 3 hours o'er him did beat, fierce rays of noontide heat. For me, thus were thou made, O mine, Lord, make me wholly thine. Give grace and strength divine to me, in thought and word and deed, thy will to do. O lead my feet, even though they bleed, to thee. Beneath the cross of Jesus, I fain would take my stand. The shadow of a mighty rock within a weary land, a home within the wilderness, a rest upon the way from the burning of the noontide heat and the burden of the day. Upon the cross of Jesus, mine eyes at times can see the very dying form of one who suffered there for me. And from my smitten heart with tears, 2 wonders I confess, the wonders of his glorious love and my unworthiness. I take, O cross, thy shadow for my abiding place. I ask no other sunshine than the sunshine of his face, content to let the world go by, to know no gain nor loss, my sinful self my only shame, my glory all the cross. Christ is walking through the streets, looking in each face he meets tenderly. Not alone in church he stands, where suppliants kneel with folded hands. Not alone in closet, where he lifts the weight of human care. But in the busy walks of life, amid the tumult and the strife, walks he with his bleeding feet. Walks he where the people meet, but they scorn him, they pass him by, and in their hearts they madly cry, "Crucify!" Christ is walking through the shops, by each workman meekly stops. Tenderly, he would lift the heavy load, he would clear the thorny road, smooth the wrinkles from each brow, wounds would heal and none allow. Walks he with his bleeding feet, walks he where the people meet, but they scorn him, pass him by, and in their hearts they madly cry, "Crucify!" Christ is walking through the slums. With his cross and thorns he comes. Painfully. Kneeling in each den of shame. Seeing things too vile to name. Yet with heart filled full of love. Bids each sinner look above. Walks he with his bleeding feet. Walks he where the people meet. But they scorn him, pass him by, and in their hearts they madly cry, crucify. Christ is walking everywhere with his face deep scarred with care, patiently. But the people lift their eyes upward yonder toward the skies, knowing not that near them stands Christ, the Lord, with pierced hands, beckoning them toward his breast, where alone they may find rest. Walks he with his bleeding feet, walks he where the people meet, but they scorn him, pass him by, and in their hearts they madly cry, crucify. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a so despised by the world as a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a the hands. The hands of Christ seem very frail, for they were broken by a nail. But only they reach heaven at last whom these frail, broken hands hold fast. One more song and then we're done. You know that survey. You know that one? You have it? When, is that how they go? When I survey.
what it is. I thought I could sing it without music. Probably could.
When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain I count but loss and pour contempt on all my pride. Forbid it, Lord, that I should boast, save in the death of Christ my God. All the vain things that charm me most, I sacrifice them to His blood. See from His head, His hands, His feet, sorrow and love flow mingled down. Did e'er such love and sorrow meet, or thorns compose so rich a crown?
Well, folks, I know it was mighty early to get up and look at this morning, and I appreciate you getting up with us and watching it with together with us, and hopefully you participated a lot as we sang. It's a day in which it's a kind of, like I say, an in-between day when we need to just remember what Christ did on the cross, remember in a kind of a grief and agony what those disciples, those early disciples felt, and realize what awesome glory awaits us tomorrow as we get ready for the Easter day. Let's close with prayer. Father, we thank you for the day. We thank you for watching over us through the night, and we pray that you would keep us steady and true in our thoughts today. If there are those who come to watch this later in the day, I pray that you would be with them and bless them even so. We pray, Father, that you would help this message that needs to be said, that it will go out and people will hear and will begin to not pass him by, to not madly cry, crucify, except perhaps that they themselves, all of us who pray, help us to be willing to crucify our own selves, our own flesh, those things that are unworthy. Help us to be able to die to the world that the Christ might live in us. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.